the Optimus Electric Uno R3 Supercomputer Kit. It's for beginners, but it does come with some pretty cool shit, and we're going to talk about it. This nifty little kit that I got was only about 10 bucks on Amazon. It does have 30 individual pieces, including the cool little storage box that it comes in. It has things like the Uno R3 controller board. It has a 25-pack of LEDs. Comes with a joystick module, a power supply module, an ultrasonic sensor. Has a breadboard, expansion board, passive buzzer, an active buzzer, 5-piece buttons, a DC connector. Comes with a 830-pin breadboard, an IR remote controller, and a TMP transistor, among other things. So this little kit is basically for beginners, but, you know, I've never really messed around with any type of modules or resistors or any kind of power or any kind of thing like that. That right there is the board. Can y'all see that? It's still in its ESD protective casing, and then that's the power supply for the breadboard. So you got a power supply, and it sits on, actually it sits this way, it sits like that on the bread, there we go, it sits like that on the breadboard, and it powers the breadboard, which is a, that's a pretty cool little feature right there. I like that. Let's see what else is in it. I've been wanting to take this apart. Oh, that's cool. Y'all see that? It's like a digital readout. Can y'all see that? That's pretty cool. That way I can build some kind of sensor or timer. What is that? That's the joystick. Has a fan. Some type of chip. Some type of computer chip. And what else is in here? Some type of module board, I guess, of some kind. Let's see what this is. Those are sensors. That must be the IR sensors, or whatever they were calling it. Yeah, the IR sensors. That must be what that is right there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of lay out all the little individual parts. So let's see here, let's back out the camera a little so y'all can see it a little bit better. There we go. Alright, these are the connectors for the breadboards. What it does is it allows me to, basically the breadboard has a bunch of little holes in it. Let's see if I can't get it out. Come on, get out. There we go. Okay, so what you do basically is you take the breadboard and then you take these little like little resistors. You see how they're all different color coding? Well, that's important. So anyway, what you do is you take it and the breadboards, here, can y'all see that? The breadboards have lines on them. Well, each line correlates with that line, and it has a positive and a negative side, and a positive and a negative side. So you kind of look at it as a north bridge and a south bridge. So what you do is you take these little connectors and you plug them into the board like that, and then what that does is that then you connect the other wire to the other part of the circuitry, and that completes the loop. So that's what that is. USB, this is a USB 3.0 cable, which I knew about. Alright, here's another, this is a display, some type of circuit board display. That's like a digital readout, because this is a analog readout, so this is a digital readout. Alright, so, oh no, well shit, I think I just may have accidentally broke that, but that's okay, I'll get another one. Oh great, another controller to hang on to. That's just what I need, is another controller. Because, you know, that's just what I need, right? Is more little remotes. Yay, more remotes. Alright, moving on. That supply to a 9-volt battery, it looks like. So that allows me to do whatever. Oh, that's cool. Like, it comes with a little like 5-volt or a little 12-volt motor, and it's also rigged up with that style of pin. Can y'all see that? It has that style of pin to allow me to plug it into the board. I guess that's what this little fan head might be for, is to go on that motor. I don't know. And then let's see what else we got in here. Okay, we got look at that. That's like some kind of little, I don't know what that is. It's some type of little module, some type of little PCB module. That's pretty cool. What else we got? Oh, we got a switch. That has to be some type of switch, right? I don't know. Let's see here. I have no idea what this is, but I guess we will find out what this is at some point. And what else we got? Oh my god, look at all the resistors. No, those are capacitors. Capacitors and resistors, I'm sure. I don't know. I'll find out what the hell this is. So that's that. And then this right here is another expansion board to allow me to make the board bigger, which is definitely a plus. This is some type of sensor, like a moisture or an air or some type of sensor. I read this, that it came with this, with some type of moisture sensor, and I guess that's what this little module is right here. Oh, comes with a little servo, and it has servo horns and some type of little servo, micro server. Servo, that's kind of cool. And then it has this, which I'm thinking that this is some type of motor, but I don't know. So we'll just put that over there. And then okay, wait a minute, those look like little switches, and those are probably capacitors right there. That looks like a capacitor. That looks like an LED, some type of LED. Can y'all see that? That's kind of cool. And those are LEDs. I know exactly. A bag full of LEDs. So, I mean, I can't believe that I got all of this stuff. I mean, look at all this stuff I got. I mean, there's still things in the bag that I haven't even fully pulled out yet. Like, here's another one of those chips. So, I got two of these computing chips, which I don't know what they do, and then some type of little sensor and stuff. So, wow, I mean, this is pretty cool. All this stuff, including the cool little nifty thing to put it together in for $10. You can't go wrong with that. That's awesome. Well, guys, that's it. Thank you so much for hanging out with me and going over my review of this little cool kit. $10, Amazon. Can't go wrong with it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put a link in the description for y'all. Check it out. I don't get any type of kickback or nothing on it, but I just want to let you guys know that this is out here, and this is for the Andrino kit, or whatever the crap you want to call it. It's kind of like the Raspberry Pi, but a lot simpler. I would start with this kit and then move my way up to the Raspberry Pi is what I would do. But thank you so much for watching, guys. Make sure to, until next time, Tech PCs, y'all be cool.